Check, check. What up, guys? Can you guys hear me?
Hello. What's up?
Can you guys hear me in the live stream chat?
Hello.
Can anybody hear us?
Oh, there's actually 9 people on.
Okay, yeah, cool. They can hear us. What up, guys?
You can hear both of us. You can hear Julian, but you can also hear me.
Is my volume too loud? Too soft? How is it, guys? Or is it just like perfect?
Oh, nice. Sick.
All right. Okay, so they can hear both of us. Nice.
That's good.
Is it morning time for you guys? Nighttime? Lunchtime? What time is it for everybody? For me, it's morning. I think for Stoad, like dinner time.
Yeah, like in an hour or two, I'm gonna eat dinner. Or at least it's dinner time, yeah.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and start. Let's see. Get everything ready here.
Julian is saying 4 p.m.
Excuse me.
Same for me, man.
Hey, Mexico.
4 p.m. here. People from Mexico.
What up, guys? Let me just set some stuff up here.
I think that's a little delay on the stream, right? Like 15 seconds, 10 seconds?
I think 10 seconds, but that's normal.
Oh, okay.
So, hold on.
As long as you guys can see the screen as well, right? You can see we're in FL Studio. You can see Yuyan's big face. To the left.
Alrighty. So I think we're showing your screen. Wait, are we?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Alright, guys. So I think right now we're going to go ahead and start with one of our new collabs with Sick, the Psycho Boys Club, and Sick, Spicy Curry.
Spicy Curry, yeah.
Yeah, right now.
In Thailand?
Yeah.
It's the idea we made in Thailand. It's a big project because we started up the idea in Bangkok, and then we worked when we got home. After that, we started to set up the whole arrangement of the song. I think in Thailand we worked on the drop or something, and then we kind of laid out the rest of the song back at our place. And we were thinking we would just wanted to showcase you guys how we made the spicy curry song from the start, like from the intro to the breakdown to the build up to the drop, and just like just show you guys how we are working and how like sound designing and mixing and all that stuff. And then after we're gonna start on a project from scratch, and just so you can see how we work on music from scratch as well. I'm gonna answer questions. If you guys have any questions, just don't be scared to type it in. Just type it, and then we can answer as many as possible. And then, of course, if you guys want to hear some new Psycho Boys Club unreleased music, we can also do that. But only if you guys are down for it.
Yeah, yeah.
So let's just get started. So you can see my screen here, of course. So
what up, Makla? Nonsense. And
yeah,
we got a bunch of people here.
Guys.
Yeah.
Let's just start with the intro. The intro is pretty straightforward. So there's not really like the intro is pretty straightforward, as I said before. It's just like kicks here and some loop we made in Thailand. I think it's
yeah, just really small, simple things.
Yeah. Then we have that alarm sounding like this one. It's actually something From Thieves? I think we got it from this
Splice Pack, yeah.
Yeah, and I think we really missed out because, like, we really missed with the sound because originally it sounds like this.
Yeah, show me about the multipass plugin. So we use this plugin a lot. It's very essential.
We use multipass. It's a plugin from Kilohertz. We use it a lot. It's an amazing plugin. And what we did with this alarm sound was we used multipass, where you can add a lot of stuff. And in this case, we added a trans gate, but you can also add like form and filtering, frequency shifting, and even delay and distortion reverb. But in this case, for this sound, we added the trans gate to give it more groove. Especially it's because in the intro, it's pretty good to keep it simple, but still interesting. And and then in the second part of the intro, we started up with the introducing the hype vocal. We have very straightforward, very simple vocal. What we did with that was basically just EQing it, crazy EQ, and putting some reverb on it. And we made it like we put some sub bass, some rolling bass as well.
Yes. Somebody's asking, how do we do the low end and like the bass triplets, basically like the rolling bass? It's pretty simple, actually. Like, if you can go ahead and show still, it's just like, we just usually just take an 808 and literally just like make a pattern of like 16th notes and then just sidechain it.
So for this case, we used like an 808 from Scott Storch. It's a hip hop producer. Let me just, like this is from a stem, but I can tell you later when we go to the drop, it's more easy to explain it. Because in the drop, there's a lot of like triplet rolling bass sound as the low end. And there's a lot of processing into it as well. So I'm gonna give you a clear walkthrough of all the stuff going on in this sound. So hopefully we can answer all of your questions. So there was a little triplet going on. Just putting up, taking a low cut on it, and then adding a sub underneath it, just fall to the floor sub, just so we got it, get it through, like keep it going. And then we're coming into the part as breakdown.
Whoa, your sound is like super buffering or like scratchy.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Still?
Yeah.
Scratchy?
Yeah, for me it is, yeah. Yeah, it's your CPU. I think people can hear it as well. Press F12 maybe to like close everything out. Just F12. And then and then go back to it. Maybe that'll help.
Let's see.
Oh god.
Is it better?
No, it's still pretty scratchy actually.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
See, it's also a really, really big project.
Yeah, it's your CPU.
82 mixing channels.
God damn. Oh, you know what? Go to options or tools. I forgot which one it is. And go to macros and switch disable all plugins when. Wait, what does it say? Hey, you go to tools, macros, and then smart disable for all plugins.
Let's see.
Sometimes that'll help saving some CPU.
Let's see. Is it better now?
No.
Oh my god, what is happening? It's not lagging for me, so that's weird.
Is it lagging for you guys? Can you hear that like his sound's like scratchy?
Is it scratchy or is it not scratchy?
Yeah, somebody said there's lag. Yeah, everybody's saying there's lag.
Fuck.
Maybe try restarting your project. Because it was fine earlier until up until this point.
Yeah.
That was weird. Sorry about that, guys. This computer sucks, as you can see clearly. Yeah, at the start it was good. That's what people were saying. Let's see.
Can you still see my screen?
No, no. Just give him 1 second, guys. So what other questions do you guys have, by the way? Like, something that we can show afterwards. I think after we show, like, our spicy curry check, maybe we can just start a scratch, like, we can start a song from scratch for you guys. So you can see exactly, like, what our process is like.
Yeah.
I don't have a collab with Dylan Francis. I don't know what you're talking about. When is the new EP coming out? We actually have, so we're working on 2 EPs. We're working on 1 solo Psycho Boys Club EP, and also a Psycho Boys and Yellow Claw EP. Pretty exciting stuff. You guys got a promo email. Actually, we do. Just psychoboysclub@gmail.com.
Yeah, just send your promos, man. We will be happy to hear whatever you guys make.
Mokla said, FO rules. Are you talking about FO Studio or Florida?
Not if it's fucking up. Can you see my screen?
No, you're not sharing it, actually.
Let me see here. Now it should work.
Yeah, okay.
Let me play.
All right.
Tell me if it's still bugging, or else we just have to show another button, I think. Jump in.
Yeah, that's good now.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's good.
Nice. Okay. So what I came from was the breakdown before it all bugged out. And the breakdown is really, really, really simple. It's basically just like the high vocal together with a sub bass, like fall to the floor, just to have like a low end that can follow the vocal into the buildup. As you can hear, it's basically just an 808, and of course the vocal, and then we have this very, very simple stuff going on, and then we merge it into the build-up where we add some snares. As you can see, there's a lot of stems. It's a big project. You guys can still hear me, right? Yeah. So it's like 82 mixing channels or something. So, yeah. So we have some snares going on in the build-up. Jump in. Pretty straightforward. It's still sounding good, right?
Yeah, it's still good.
Okay. So the build-up is not really that, like, it's not that special. It's just like a snare. It's like an introduction from the synth that I'm going to explain what we did. It's from the trap, just some rise-ups. And yeah, just the sub-bass pitching up, basically.
Yeah, maybe show them like some processing tricks rather than just like arrangement, like, for example, like the lead and stuff, like what we like show exactly like what kind of tweaking we did.
Oh,
you know,
yeah, but that's in the drop.
Yeah,
and let me play here. We can do this. It's drop, so we can start. That's actually 2 sounds going on in the drop, like 2 synths, and in this case, it really depends on what kind of song we want to make. But this song, we want it to be loud and hit hard, really. So we use like a bass one shot from Tsuzoki. It's from his sample pack. Without processing. Really thin, cheap. I even cut some of the outs. So it's very, not really outstanding, what you call it. But then we did a lot of stuff in the process, and I think we started like Soundgardizer to make it more I think I don't know really what sound condensing does. I don't know if it's a multi-band compression or something, but it at least makes the sound more colorous and more compressed.
Yeah, it's basically a like half saturator, half multi-band compressor. It's actually like a small part of I think Maximizer. No, what is it called? The FL plugin.
Maximus.
Yeah.
So we started with that, and then just some simple EQing where we took off the lows and put some high mid and a little bit of the highs as well. And then we used the plugin again, like multipass, that I know me and Yuyan, we use this a lot.
Yeah, pretty much every project, every lead, we use multipass in some way.
It's so good to like process like synths and lead and just like really make the sounds more harsh and more outstanding, what you can call it. Yeah, so basically what I did was I started out to use like a Forman filter, and the Forman filter is basically Forman the filter, like it's really hard to explain what it does, but it kind of,
in a way, it's almost like a frequency shifter kind of. But it still keeps like the same. No, I'm sorry. It still keeps like the same frequency, but it just kind of just molds the sound.
It basically manipulates the sound.
Yeah.
Within the sound. And then there's like the saturator. It definitely makes the more distorted, colorish, give it more drive as well.
Yeah.
And then just like basic reverb. I think I used reverb twice actually, when I see like here and here. And it's really, really simple. I cannot recommend more that just get multipass, because all these plugins within multipass you can use, and it's just like next level stuff.
Yeah, and also like
to make really, really, really good, like strong leads. And in this case, we just use samples, but the synth from that sample, you can make it so much like so powerful, like it's crazy.
Yeah. Plus, like one cool thing about multipass, you see here how like you have like those three bands in the middle, like the 250 hertz. What's the other one? 3000. So you can actually like add an effect on a like specific frequency. For example, if you only want like the low end, what they like overdrive distortion, you can do that. It's pretty cool.
There's a lot of things you can do. You can put, yeah, of course, like frequency shifting. You can manipulate like
work
sound itself.
Where can you get it? You can just go to kilohertz.
Kilohertz. I don't know if you know that. It's KI, hello, and hertz. So that's basically what we did with that synth. And then, of course, I put a little reverb on it, just a tiny bit. I actually think it's automation clipped, so it comes in after every fourth bar or something. Then I used LFO tool to sidechain it, to sidechain the synth. And that's basically it. It was this one. You could just hear how, not really like, without any processing, it sounds so boring. It's like really thin, but then boom, in your face. And then that was the other synth we used. It was this one. It's also actually from Tsuzuki, his sample pack. And the original, like without any processing, was sounding like this. And after the process, it sounds like, so you can also hear how much we actually did do. So basically for this, we actually did a lot of processing with this because we wanted to be more outstanding. And this should definitely be the groove of the song, like the rollingness. So what we wanted to do with that sound is has to be following the rolling bass underneath it. So what I did was I used Isotope Alloy 2. It's actually a plugin Yuyan, he showed me. I think I used a preset called Punchy Synth within the synth.
Yeah, basically, this plugin is a really good transient designer.
Yeah, really, like, it's basically also parallel compression, right?
Yes.
I think it is, yeah. It also says that, yeah. And then I use a plugin called CamoFat. I don't know if you guys know that. It's actually, I think it's an older plugin.
Yeah, I think everybody knows this one. It's like the first distortion plugin that people are introduced to, I think.
Yeah, I remember back in the day, the hardstyle guys used this a lot. I don't know if they still do. Within that, I tweaked it. I think I have it in, yeah, it's called SFX Combo. And then I tweaked it a lot, like the flanger a little bit. No, the flanger is off, but the MM fill is on. So I took down the cutoff a little bit, took up the resonance. That's basically it. Still, like, it's a preset, but I tweaked it a little bit. And it was just to make it more like distorted, to give it another kind of feeling. And then we put the Isotope Trace on. And I think what I did there was using Nasty Boy under Heavy. I pull up the shape a little bit to give it more body. Then I went into the Convolve and used something called TV Scoop to make it more, called dynamic, something more outstanding. Like a lot of what I do when I produce music, I have no musical background, so I just do whatever I think sounds good to my ears and just go with the flow. That's really, really important to do. Yeah, I use some OTT, multiband compression, or what do you call it?
Yeah, probably one of the best plugins to ever use, honestly. It's good for so many things, for anything actually. For leads,
Yeah.
drums, vocals.
Basis as well, yeah.
I use it for like anything actually, everything.
Yeah. And for this we took down this one to 57 and some depth as well. And then this Forman filtering. You saw it before, I used it in the other synth on the multipass. This is also the Kilohertz plugin. If you buy this, you can get not only the multipass, but you get the separate VSTs as
Yeah.
well. So you can use them separate, so you don't have to open up multipass every time to use, like, for example, Forman filtering or something. So what I did was just playing around with this. You can see there's letters inside of it, so it's
They're basically
trying
vowel.
to.
Yeah, it
Yeah,
like
it tries to make that, for example, if it's over the E, it will try to make the sound like E, or what you call it.
Yeah.
Basically, yeah.
Like just the vowel sounds.
Yeah.
Somebody
Yeah.
asked if why don't you use a dry wet knob? I guess for OTT, is that what you're talking about? Bach music? I'm actually not sure which one he's talking about.
No.
Oh, in trash, in trash.
Oh, in class?
I guess for that it's just preference, honestly.
Oh, you mean with?
Yeah, that one,
I
yeah.
do that sometimes. I actually do that when I use Isotope Trash for like kicks and stuff, basses. But I don't know, like if it sounded good, it sounds good. Like it doesn't.
Yeah, I mean that's like the number one rule. If it sounds good to you, then it's good.
Then just cue it, yeah. After the Forman filtering, I used some EQing, just taking off the, or we use like taking off the, what you call, low end. So it didn't interfere with the sub bass and the rolling basses going on. And then, of course, a LFO tool for sidechaining. So that's basically the two synths. And then we have up here on top is actually just a standard 808. It's basically, or it's just like from the stem, but it's just like the rollingness from the sub. I guess this is the basically the sub bass, or what you call it. And that's just like we take off the high cuts and stuff and put a sidechain on it. In this case, I use LFO 2. Actually, we use LFO tool a lot for sidechaining, but you can also use like, I don't know, like what sidechaining plugins do you guys use? Like Kickstart, or just like Fruity Balance, or just Groove Speed? Or do you guys also use LFO tool?
Yo, so somebody's asking if you can solo all of the lead layers so they can hear them one by one.
No, I don't want to do that. Let's do it. Can you still hear the sounds like without bugging? Like it's good sounding?
Yeah, it's still pretty clean. Yeah. Or a plate?
The first lead.
Yeah.
That was the first one.
By the way, for sidechaining, you should definitely try to use LFO 2. I feel like that has a lot more creativity. It has a lot more freedom. You know, you can shape exactly how you want sounds to sidechain. It's also really easy to do. You just draw in how you want it to sound. You should try that.
Yeah, definitely agree. Shaperbox is actually also a good plugin. I can see Buck Music is saying Shaperbox. It's really underrated plugin as well.
Yeah.
Okay, so the second sound I use, like I talked about before, is sounding like this. But basically, that's the main, what you call, drive in this song. And of course, the LO, like... that's the low end.
Okay, I think you're starting to scratch again. Play?
Really?
Play something? Yeah, you're starting to bug out, actually.
Fuck's sake. sorry for closing. Okay. Let me... we are so sorry, guys. It's because it's just a really, really big plugin. Not a project. We have three guys working on this on three separate... project, so
yeah, it's all good.
I tried to combine it within one project, so it's just really, but it's the sounds gonna get better too.
I think that's fine for now. So I'm gonna go ahead and switch to my screen. I kind of want to show you some vocal processing tricks, if you don't mind. Let's see.
Do it.
So turn that off. All right, so you guys can see my screen now, right? Yeah. So we have like this little project that we're working on. I'm actually not sure if we're gonna use this vocal, but you know, I just use it for fun, just to show you guys some processing. I'm gonna play a little bit here for you.
Yeah, I don't think we can hear any sound.
No, no sound.
No audio.
Oh, yeah, I used the wrong driver. Give me a second here. What about now, guys?
No. No audio.
Yeah, they can hear now.
Again?
Yeah. Well, they can, but you can't.
Oh, that's fine.
Life goes on. We drift deeper into the sun, feeling strong. Alright guys, so here's what I did with the vocal. I'm gonna turn these off for now. I'm gonna turn off the plugins that I use. So here's what the vocal sounds, just dry. Let's see. Somewhere could be anywhere. There's a coldness in the air. So what I did, I started out with just doing some basic EQing. I wrote off about like 222 hertz. Added some OTT. I actually didn't really do much on OTT. I just like how it sounds, just as like a limiter, basically, just with like 50% depth and literally touch nothing. But then the next thing I did was like I added a reverb bus here. And so what I have on this chain, it's literally just only reverb stuff. So basically I have Comet. It's a really nice, like really pretty reverb plugin.
Really, really good reverb plugin. It's definitely also an underrated plugin.
Yeah, I think I like this one more than Valhalla. Yeah, this one's kind of like under the radar. I like this one more than Valhalla because it's very less CPU intensive. But anyway, so I have the reverb. Then I have a Fab filter. So I have like this compressor. And what I'm doing with this, it's I'm sidechaining the reverb to the vocal. That way when the vocal is playing, all of the reverb is ducking. So you don't really like hear all that like mess. And then once the vocal is like taking a break, when there's like a pause or something, the reverb comes back up. So it has like this really cool like ducking, pumping effect. After that I have just like a flanger effect, which is only affecting the reverb. And then again I have another like EQ, which is like cutting the lows off the reverb and a little bit of the highs. Then I added a delay bus, which is affecting only the reverb. For this one, I'm using this plugin from Native Instruments, Replica XT. Let's see, what questions do we have? Why use flanger and reverb? I don't know, it just has like a really cool effect that I like. You know, it's just preference. It has like a really 90s ravey vibe, which is like what Psycho Boys is all about.
Yeah.
And then I do the same thing here.
It's like exploring sounds and tricks.
Yeah, for movement. Yeah.
Yeah.
So let me play this one by one. Traveling somewhere could be anywhere. And if I were to turn off the sidechain, it sounds like this. Traveling somewhere could be. You see how like it's really messy now? Like you just hear the reverb as soon as the vocal goes. Yeah, that's why it's important to sidechain it. Then I add the delay on here. Traveling somewhere could be anywhere.
There's a coldness in the air, but I don't care. Especially good for kind of music we are making right now. A lot of energy in it, but also a lot of feels.
Oh, by the way, is your project backed up to finish the Spicy Curry track before we move on?
Yeah.
Are you sharing your screen?
I am in a second. Now! You can see my screen.
Yeah, it can be a second here.
I don't know.
Hold on guys, I'm gonna go ahead and switch to Stolt screen.
Yeah, just to wrap up the drop.
Yeah, here we go. Okay, now you're on Stolt.
Start something from scratch.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just gonna test to see if you can hear it without any scratchiness.
Yeah, we're good.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Good? Okay, cool. So we basically talked about the synths and stuff, how we process it. I talked a little about the rolling bass, like the subbiness. It's basically really simple stuff. And within this drop, we have a lot of like fills you can see here, like here and here. It's basically just fills within the, like the holes of the synths, just to make it more interesting.
Yeah, it's really important to have that because it just adds, you know, to the background. It just helps make the track like fill itself up. That's why it's called a filler.
Yeah, exactly. So in the second part of the drop, we switched it up a little bit and made it. You can hear it's more lower in the highs, and I added we added like this sound. It's basically just the first synth, but just like put like a whole octave down, and then I did some processing to it again, and again used like Farman filtering, because it's a really, really good plugin to use, especially if you want to switch it up in the second part of your drops. Play around with Farman filtering is always good, and just like basic EQing. Boosting the highs a little bit. I used a little reverb, and oh, I think this is in the build up. I used this for the build up. That's basically it for the drop. And I think like the second breakdown is basically the same as the first.
Yeah.
So maybe just move to the second drop, because we switched it up a little bit in the second drop.
Yeah, let's do that.
Is the audio still good?
Yeah, it's still good. Jump in.
You guys hear it? Is it okay?
Yeah, should be.
So, in the second drop, we switched it up a little bit, because we felt like it would be too boring to just copy-paste the first drop into the second drop. It would be too easy, especially if we had have a really, really simple breakdown and build-up as well. So what we did here was, besides changing the synth, you can see here is this synth here. From the first drop, it sounded like this. In the second drop, it sounds like this. So the energy is different, and of course the MIDI, or like the positions of that synth, is also different. We use this bass again.
Somebody asked how many kicks and how did you process them, and did you cut the tail off or not?
Oh yeah, good question actually. For this song, we used like two kicks. I'm sorry, I haven't mentioned it. I should have in the first drop.
Yeah.
But I used two kicks for this. The first kick is this one.
Just like a really punchy, in your face, yeah. Kind of just... high,
I don't think
high top.
Any more punchy than this, and then we use this kick, and that's more to
the body.
That's a kind of a body of it, yeah. It's the processing for this kick is, I don't really process kicks so much like that much, especially when it's all like the sample is already like this, so I just boost it like this. A little bit,
yeah. And yeah, normally we use like two kicks on average, like just a top kick and a body kick.
Yeah, it's good to merge kicks, and especially you like, of course it's good to have them in the same key, but if something sounds good even though it's not on key, like kick wise it's still really good to do that. To come back to the second drop, I added, we added a little rolling bass. Actually, I think I cut it out from a loop. Let me play it.
Yeah, just
solo.
Maybe, yeah, solo it.
And then. And it sounds. But it's without any processing on it. And then when you turn the processing on, it sounds like this. So it has more of a groove to it, and it's just like a basic
rolling bass,
trance bass shop, I would say, that you put into like a rolling bass pattern. Again, Farman filtering, and then LFO tool for sidechaining, and then of course cutting off the lows, because you already have a sub bass. So it's really important not to merge these two kick basses, because then the subness will be chaotic and clash with each other. So yeah, so we just like took off the low end of that. Again, as you can see, we use the same fillers. And in the second part of the drop, like last drop, we also switched it up a little bit. The audio is still good, right?
Yeah.
Cool. So in the second part of the drop, of the second drop, we consolidated this one.
Wait, show them how to do that. So it's this really nice trick in FL 20. It's basically the same as freezing tracks in Ableton. But go ahead and.
I actually don't know how many of you guys are using FL Studio.
Yeah, but.
Some of you did, right?
Yeah, for those of you who are watching that are using it, yeah, show them how to use it. So, like, how to,
So for this bass, like for example, if I want to do something with this one, and I want to say like I want to cut some things out, I can mark this and press Control Alt C. Then this little thing comes up.
Actually, they can't see that part. No. But
Oh, they
basically,
cannot.
no, so basically, you just hit enter after you hit Control Alt C, and it'll freeze it,
Oh, okay.
which is what he's doing now. It's basically bouncing it and inserting it into
Oh,
the,
yeah.
yeah.
Let me.
Where'd he go?
Oh, yeah. I did it wrong, actually.
Ah,
No, it's
nice.
just like Rexha, so
What a
here.
noob.
Yeah, sorry. It's just wanted to bounce the whole song. So basically, here
There we go.
it comes. Yeah. So this is the. It's basically what I just bounced out. You
Got
can. What I know what you do a lot and what I do a lot is just especially, and we're gonna show you after we have done this breakthrough with this song, we're gonna start a drop from scratch and show you how we work, for example, on a drop. And we use consolidate a lot because we
Yeah.
want to tweak the synth or like the lead synth and sounds so much just to be more unique and see if how good you can make the drop, like do the best you can do.
Yeah, it's basically just resampling, which gives you like a lot
Yeah,
more ideas, more
exactly.
freedom to like mess the sound up more and stuff. Yes, it's only FL
That's
20.
basically that song, actually, and then the outro comes out, and that's it. It's not more going on, actually.
Yep. So that's that.
So I was thinking maybe Yuyin, do you want to open up like a new fresh project and then we can show them?
Yeah. Let me go and switch screens here. Hold on.
What's the email for feedback? Got a banger for you guys.
I
Nice.
should we create one just for demos? Because I don't think we have a demo email.
Don't think we have a demo email, but you guys can always send me like promos to like stoltenhoffmusic@gmail.com.
Or actually, yeah, let's go ahead and like so while I make a like a beat from scratch, can you go ahead and just make like a promos dot psychoboysclub at Gmail just so we have an email specifically for that?
Yeah,
I think
yes.
that's probably the best. Yeah. By the way, guys, I think we're gonna perhaps like maybe stream at least once a week, I think. But we're gonna do it on our own Twitch. So if you guys have like a second to like follow us on our Twitch, which is twitch.tv/psychoboysclub, that'll be cool. That'd be cool.
Yeah.
Hey, what up, Andy? All right, can you see my screen? Oh yeah. All right, let's see what we got here. What BPM should I do this,
Should we
guys?
like just do like 150 or 160? Something quick, something hard. That's probably what they want to hear, right, guys?
Yeah, 150, 160, 170. What we got?
200 BPM.
200. Nah, maybe not 200. Maybe not 200. Not today.
That's for Little Texas, man.
150. Okay, I got a bunch of 150s. I got 160. Let's see. 150. Okay, so I think 150 is the winner here. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. All right. So let me look for a nice kick. Actually, hold on. I do have this 909 pick I like. So you're just like a basic 909 kick, straight from like the 909 sampler. Maybe I'll use this, maybe I'll change it, not sure. By the way, so let me know when you have that email set up.
Yeah, I'm doing it as we speak.
Like a build-up snare.
Do you guys hear his what he's doing? Like, is there any sound? Do you hear?
Can you guys hear? Yeah, they can hear. Cool.
Alright, so I just we just made an email just for you guys can send promos to us.
Nice. And what's the email?
The email is psychoboysclubpromos@gmail.com.
Let me see if I can type that on the chat. Demos. Psycho Boys Club promos or demos? What did you say?
Promos.
Promos. At gmail.com?
Yeah.
There we go. I don't know if you guys can see what I typed. It might be lost in the chat. I don't know. It's the one that's... It's from June Sabobo. Demos. So send your demos to psychoboysclubpromos@gmail.com. And we'll check it. Maybe we can actually do a stream just for, you know, just for checking people's demos and give them light feedback. Yeah. I think that would be cool.
That's... Pretty cool, yeah.
Oh, and again,
send your best goddamn shit.
And here's the our Twitch link. Give me a second. Yeah, twitch.tv/psychoboysclub. Cool.
So Julian, what are you gonna make? What kind of drop?
I don't know. I kind of want to do it like 170. But right now I'm just doing.
Then do it 170.
Yeah. Wait. Actually, can you see? Oh no, I need to share my screen to you, huh?
I can see.
From the stream though, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's fine.
So right now I'm just working on like a build up. So I'm using the same snare underneath, like and it gives it a some kind of like rhythm, you know, like when you like change volumes, cause since there's like a double snare, these would be a slightly louder, and it just gives that like false rhythm thing rather than just automating the volume. It's a pretty cool trick.
I'm still giving it groovy.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it just gives it groove. That's what I was trying to say.
Send the demo, hope you guys like it. Yeah, we're gonna check all the demos, promos out you guys send us, I think later this week. We can do it like live on stream as well. We can give you guys feedback if you want that. That could be fun to do.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna make this project 170 just for fun. Fuck it. Fuck it, man.
Do it, man. When is the Warzone Masterclass?
Nice. Yeah, who's out playing Warzone, by the way? That's like probably like my favorite Battle Royale game out of all the ones that have been released.
I think I only got one win. I played like 50 games or something.
God, you suck.
Yeah. Yeah, we played on the computer, both you and I. There's a lot of people playing on PS4 as well, I think. Levi, like the from Raw Tech, he's playing on Xbox.
Yeah, it's crossplay. Just pretty nice.
Yeah, that was more like crossplay.
Yeah. Shout out to XNG, if you guys are watching, you guys have a crazy sample pack.
Can you share screen so I can hear as well? Then
share screen. I wonder if I would be laggy if I share it to you, but yeah. Should I do the application window? Or just entire screen?
Just whatever.
Okay. Well, so you can hear me, I guess. Whoa. I can already see that it's being weird for you. One second.
Sounds like Little Texas.
There we go.
Thank you.
we're pretty much where. Yeah, I download like sample packs every day, like just random ones. You never know what can be used. And plus, it's like if you're ever like stuck with like a writer's block or something, I think it's really useful to just spend a day downloading a bunch of sample packs. That way you're bound to gain some new ideas.
Just use Splice as well. But I bet a lot of you people are already using, you guys are using Splice. Right? It's really good.
These are weird sounds. Actually, I don't like these sounds. I put some drums in here.
But it's really exciting to see how the process is, because even if Ewan, he's working on, now he started from scratch, or even if I do, or maybe also you guys can follow what I'm saying. It's just like, it's a big process. Like, you probably have an idea in your head, but how do you kind of draw it out? Or like, how do you find the right sounds? How do you process it? And it can also, like, it can take hours. Sometimes they can take like 20 minutes and then you have a really sick drop. Other times you work on the same drop for like 2 days or something. It's different.
How did you shift where your, wait, how did you shift where the samples hits like that? How did you, okay.
Like, so, you mean the hotkeys you're using?
Yeah. So if you're using FL, for example, like I have this kick and I want to like change where it's hitting, I press S, which is, where is it on here? Oh, okay. So this right here. You change it to slip mode. Then from here, have like these two left and right arrows. From here, you can just like move it around and stuff. It's pretty cool. Like, especially if you have like a lead with like a bunch of like MIDIs and stuff, you can like make certain things start or end differently. I use that all the time, actually.
Will we see masterclasses from Barong family artists often?
That's very possible, yeah. I mean, like we said before, like for those of you who are just now like joining in or whatever, we're gonna try to do like a Psycho Boys Twitch stream, like at least like once a week.
Yeah, once or twice a week at least, yeah.
Yeah.
Gonna make music. You can see how we work and what songs we actually are working on as well. We have a lot of new songs.
Yeah, we have like probably like 50, honestly.
And also, I think after you and his make something he's satisfied with, he should probably play you guys some unreleased music.
Oh yeah, yeah. We should give him like, you know, maybe 30 seconds preview of stuff.
Yeah, just a couple of,
just for fun.
We have this sick collab with the Paul Elstack. That's like 170 BPM. It's really, the song is really good. We have a song with DJ Soda as well coming out, in a couple of months. It's such a different song that me and Yurian are used to release.
It's not showing on my screen, but right now I'm just loading up Splice to find a sound that I can like further tweak. Let's see what questions you guys have here. What DAW we're using? So we both use FL Studio 20, just like the newest version, the most updated one.
I actually used FL Studio 10, I think 1.5 years ago. And then I switched to 20 because Yuen, he said it was
the best.
Nicer to do it. And it's just easier to do that.
I've actually been using like FL Studio for probably like 10 years, honestly. I've had it for a really long time.
Yeah, I started when it was like FL Studio 9, actually. And then I just worked my way up.
That's a cool sound.
How is your process? Do you each make a track and send it to each other?
Yep.
So, yeah. Basically, me and Julian, we have studio sessions. A couple of days a week, like 2 or 3 times a week.
Yeah, I would say so. 2 or 3 times.
Yeah, and we use Discord a lot because you can screen share, and then we just work from there. For example, Ewan, he can have a breakdown idea, and he just send it over, and then I work on a drop, and vice versa. I can have an idea, and he's gonna work on it. And it's so fun to use like Discord to it for it, and especially like the screen share, because you can see how the like you can help giving feedback on point, like instead of like sending it to an email and just wait a couple of hours or days even for feedback, you can give feedback right away, and then the workflow is way much easier. I also think that's why me and Yuyan are really really productive, that we already have like a lot of songs, also because we like to challenge each other, especially like the sounds, especially for Psycho Boys Club. Like we want to have like a really unique sound with a twist of old school and ravey stuff in it.
I think I made a cool thing here.
How can you decide the duration for intro of a track? Well, it depends on what kind of song you're making. It's just like keep a simple intro, but yeah. Interesting.
No, but he's saying that.
You always use elements. What you have in the song that's coming in later, just use that as well.
Yeah. Plus, like. The intro nowadays, I think everybody just makes it like 30 seconds. You know, I think that's like the standard now.
Yeah. Are you gonna make a PBC sample pack or preset pack?
I've been thinking about it actually. I mean, I think we should definitely do that.
I think we also like, but we cannot say that right now. It's too early. But that's probably gonna come like a sample pack.
Yeah.
This year. It's a shame Discord don't advertise more to non-gaming communities. Yeah. It is. Is there a way to send you guys our music and get tips? Yes. You can send your music, your demos, promos to psychoboysclubpromos at gmail.com. We just created one just for you guys to send your music. Where do you get vocals? From studios or Splice or something?
Also Fiverr. Fiverr is a good source to find like really original stuff. You know, you can hire somebody for literally $5 to like, I don't know, $50, $100. Yeah. And you get some really good studio quality vocals to your liking.
Sometimes you can get a really cool Splice vocal sample. But nowadays it's just like everyone is using them. So you have to be more creative with your vocal. So what Julian's saying is like Fiverr is you can get professional vocalists to sing for so but not like none. So an amount of money, basically $5 or something. Or you can get in the studio with a singer. It's more expensive. We could do all three actually. I don't know. It depends. Any tips for people new to music production? Just study the genre of music you want to make. I used so many hours studying YouTube tutorials for FL Studio, for example, because I use FL Studio. I don't know which store you're using, but there's a lot of tutorials. I think not only for FL Studio, but also Ableton and Logic and YouTube. It's gonna take a lot of hours to get started, to get good to make music, but it will come. Yes. Sacrifice Club promos at gmail.com. Jungle Terror vibe, like 128 plus BPM, like the slower vibes. And then we just evolve ourselves into a quicker BPM, especially.
I think nowadays we're like really inspired by like 90s rave, like really dark techno stuff. And like that's basically like what Psycho Boys is, you know, but with their own twist.
Guys, have any advice for producers who get demotivated and who think they will make it big in the scene? Yeah, that's a thing a lot of people struggle with, especially within the music business. It's hard to say like you have to keep push yourself, especially if you want to release music, or it depends if you only want to be a DJ or producer, but at least for me, I love making music, but I also like to DJ. But you have to stay relevant, if you know what I mean? Like you have to keep making music. So, but yeah, don't get demotivated.
Let's see. Yeah, I got something here. It's kind of simple. Let's see.
So that's a question for you, Julian. What's the pitch change? Three semitones? So why did you choose three semitones?
Actually, I just chose one. The range is one, so it's just only going up one semitone. But there's like a lot of what is it called? Like centi tones? Like just really small pitch effects here going. I don't know. I was just messing around, honestly.
Messing around, yeah.
Yeah.
Is it really necessary to buy FL Studio, or could we like make good things in the trial?
You actually can't save a project in trial mode, or even
I
like
you
bounce.
Have to buy the FL Studio, yeah. I think the FL Studio producer edition is the cheapest one, right?
I'm sorry. What was it?
User edition for FL Studio is the cheapest.
Yeah, yeah.
You guys should do some tutorials soon on 128 or even 150. Okay. As Julian, he mentioned before, but also to you new coming in watching the stream, is that we're gonna stream on Twitch one or twice a week. Psycho Boys Club, and we will work music, we will give tips and tricks, and we just gonna you guys can see our workflow.
Let's see, what is your mixing chain?
Where do you give feedback on the demo? Do you reply it if it's good, or on the stream? I think we're gonna do.
Yeah, we should definitely do it on stream. If it's good or bad,
good.
Yeah, like if it's bad, I'm gonna tell you what's bad about it. You know, like I'm gonna give you like the real, the real feedback.
Super honest with his feedback. I'm good with constructive feedback. So
I mean, it's helpful, you know, because you don't want to be hopeful.
You have to be constructive.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I'm gonna do it like in a good constructive way. You know, I'm gonna tell you that it's shit, but I'm gonna tell you why it's shit, and then I'm gonna tell you how to not make it shit. You know.
But yeah, but we can also reply to emails. But I think now we just made the email just for you guys to send your demos promos. So I think it could be fun to do it on a live stream on our trip. And you can, then everyone can listen to your demo, and then we can give like good constructive feedback to it.
I'm almost done here, and then we can start showing some unreleased Psycho Boy stuff, and then I think we're gonna end the stream from there.
Are you guys both CET? That's the time thing. No, we are not. I am, I think, right?
Wait, what?
Denmark, and it's like 5 p.m. And
I don't know
what time. I think it's 11 a.m. at Julian's place right now.
Yeah, my time zone is Central. I live in Dallas, Texas. United States. Okay. Yeah, so it's 11 a.m.
It's 11 a.m. his place, 5 p.m. my place. Because I live in Scandinavia, Denmark. Woo! Julian for techno, how much BPM is it? So, depends what kind of tech you want. Techno can be really slow, like all the way to 120 BPM, but you can also make like hard techno, like the faster BPM, and it's all like all up to like 150 BPM. Stoltenhoff, Valentin Kahn usually drops one of your unreleased tunes that has sort of vortex in there. It might be around 130 or 140. So actually, me, Julian, and Valentino Kahn actually work. We give each other feedback on music all the time. We always talk music with each other. And we are also working on a new song together, like a PPC Valentino Kahn song. So yeah, I think Valentin Kahn plays out a lot of me and Julian's songs.
Yeah, here we go. Just a simple Psycho Boys little clip here. I'm gonna go ahead and show you some
guys stuff. Did you choose which artist you were gonna work with on the Heart in Bangkok album? You did.
It was random. Yeah.
It was super random. Like it was just like random. It was not something we chose.
Yeah, basically like the people behind Barong Family, like the managers, they wrote a schedule every night, just, you know, just see who would make sense together, who wouldn't make sense together, you know, just kind of just random.
Also try to challenge us.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Because it's fun to put a hardcore DJ with a bombaton DJ. A producer, like, what can they get out of being in the studio? New Psycho Boys Club EP this summer?
Maybe. Oh, we need to finish it first.
We're working on two EPs now. But because of the whole coronavirus thing, it's going to be a little delayed, I think, with the schedule. But yeah, the plan was to have a EP released this summer. But let's see.
Yeah,
it's going to be that's going to be two Psycho Boys Club EPs this year. 100% for like 8 songs. We have so much music, guys. We have a lot of singles coming up as well.
Yeah, I think right now we have about 3 singles, 2 EPs, and like, I don't know, 100 some collabs. Yeah, we have a remix.
Yeah.
So right now I'm gonna show you guys like a little preview of this track we're working on. I think we're naming it Hardcore Power. But yeah, let me just show you what we have so far.
And as you can see, the pratik is a lot of stems, and that's because we bound stems to each other, so it's we can always have the full arrangement, and then we can play around it.
I'll make sure the lead's on. Okay.
Well, is that the updated one?
It's actually like the earlier version, but you know, just for a preview at least. All right, guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and play this. So if you guys have any questions, just go ahead and ask while I play. Wait, what? So far, what else should we show them still?
Yeah, should we, before we end this stream, do you guys want to hear more like unreleased songs we have coming up? What do you guys think?
Julian, where is your siren? Well, this is a Psycho Boys club, man, so we only use a Psycho Boys tag. No more Julian siren.
Psycho Boys no. Club. Psycho Boys Club. Psycho Boys Club. Psycho Boys Club.
Shut up.
Show them.
Show us your underwear. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, you first. Sedano X Stro. Play your collab.
The Paul L. Stack collab.
Okay, let's see.
You don't have to use that. You don't have to show the project. Just play it because it's easier.
What was the name of it? Bull Piss? No, Bull Kick.
Bull Piss. Which one of you did the tag? Actually, this song is a girl called Samira.
Yeah, shout out to Samira. Samira Davidson.
Malaysia. Is it Malaysia she's from?
Yeah, Malaysia, KO. She has a really, really cool multi-accent voice. But yeah.
Why are you not on Hard in Bangkok? He actually is. He has like 3 songs.
Yeah, what are you guys talking about? Right now, I've released 2 songs. The first song
he has a new one coming up this Friday as well.
Yeah, that one I can't tell you what it is yet, just gotta wait. But so far I've released Super Noise with Ray Ray and Yellow Claw. The second one I did under Psycho Boys and Sick Spicy Curry. Yeah.
And then the third one is coming Friday, and then you have to wait. Carnage vs PBC is my dream. Yeah, it will be fun to work with him.
Alright guys, so here's the Paul Elstack and Psycho Boys Club Bull Kick track.
Let's play something.
Shit. Y'all ready? Everybody jump and bounce.
Go!
jumping bells. Everybody jumping bells. DJ
Paulhouse, the killer. Yep, that's all you get for now. What else can we show them still?
I don't know.
So yeah, how much time do we have? Just a few minutes, maybe just two more songs, and then from there we just answer your questions for a little bit. And I think we're gonna end the stream from there, guys. June, when are you going to work with Lil Texas? I have. We have a track called what is it called? Rush Hour. June Sebulba, Lil Texas, Rush Hour. We even have a really cool music video. So, you should go check that out. Wait, where's our... Oh.
Yeah, maybe just play one more.
Yeah, one more. Okay, so we have like 20 songs, guys. Pick a number between 1 and 17 in the comments. Yeah, and then I'm gonna pick the song of that number. Okay, so we got 7, 12, we got 15, what else? Okay, we got 3 12s, 2 13s, 3 13, so it's a tie between 12 and 13. Oh, 3 17s, oh shit. Come on, guys, what do we got?
Maybe. Now, what did we show them? Did we show like Heart Based Power and
Polar? Yeah.
What about the that's Flippy Flop?
17 was the best. You guys don't even know what song that is yet.
That's the SR collab. Do you guys want to hear the collab we have with the SR? SR, the French.
Either the SR collab or Trek. Number 17, whichever that one that is.
That's actually which is also it? Track 17. The SR collab is also track 17, to be honest.
Wait, no, it's not. I'm looking at the PBC promos 2020 folder.
Yeah, me too.
What? Yeah, the first one is actually the SR collab for me.
Oh, really? Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
Okay, so a SR collab or Yellow Claw remix? Which one?
Yeah, you guys can choose Yellow Claw remix or a SR collab. It's a hard pick, yeah. And you only get to listen to it for 30 seconds.
30 seconds, okay. 30 seconds.
And one, I think the is.
Yeah, okay. Looks like.
I think it's Yellow Claw.
The Yellow Claw remix. Alrighty, guys, here we go. What's the BPM on this? 35, right? 135?
I think so.
So only playing 30 seconds, right?
Yeah. Okay. Just start from the breakdown and the build-up. Don't act up, twist your back up. This opportunity to get that ass up. You wanna get wild, oh! Take it from the sky to the ground right now. Don't act up, twist your back up. This opportunity to get that ass up. You wanna get wild, oh! Take it from the sky to the ground, in the ground, wanna get wild.
Well, that's that.
Nice.
All right, guys, we have about like a few minutes. We can just do some questions for now, some Q&A. By the way, for those of you who are just like now joining in, make sure you follow us on Twitch. Again, it's twitch.tv/psychoboysclub. Yeah, we're gonna try to stream some more stuff on there, maybe like some more studio tips. Maybe some demo feedback, some live feedback for you guys. I think that would be fun.
Just send a lot of your demos and promos to Psycho Boys Club promos.
Yeah.
At gmail.com. We're gonna have a live feedback on it sometime soon.
Let's see what questions we have here. Will you guys have a Jersey Club song? I don't know. I don't think Jersey Club really matches the Psycho Boys vibe, but who knows? Maybe we can do some kind of Jersey Club, techno, underground, hybrid. Who knows? But at the moment, it's not really our thing. When did Stoughton Hoof start to make music? When did you start to make music, Stoughton?
I think it's like 6 or 7 years ago.
When he was 6 years old, he was already making hardstyle.
Yeah, no. I think I have been making music for like 6, 7 years. 7 years probably.
Yeah, I would say same. Like, I think I started, I guess, like professionally when I was like 19, 18, 19. That's when I started looking up production tutorials and that. I just started being more serious about it. And I don't think I signed my first song until I was like 20, 21. Yeah.
Yeah, which song was your first time? Was it like Super Jam?
Yeah, Super Jam on Mad Decent. For your kick, you usually use two kicks and one of these with distortion. Yeah, I think on average we use two kicks, you know, one top kick, but like just, you know, just really clean one, and then one body kick where the, you know, distortion can be.
Yeah. And then a sub.
Yeah, we definitely want to work with Lil Texas. I actually, so he called me like a few days ago. We were talking about doing some stuff together. He told me to hit him up in a few days so we can just start talking, you know, Psycho Boys, Lil Texas collab. So yeah, that would definitely happen. Definitely needs to happen. Will you come to Russia?
Make some really dope old school.
Yeah, that would be sick. Some old school hardcore. That's also
that's sick.
A big inspiration. When's Dither streaming? I don't know. We come to Russia. Yeah, we definitely want to come to Russia. I think we kind of just want to go everywhere as soon as, you know, this whole virus thing is
gone.
By the way, guys, stay safe. Stay indoors and stuff.
Stay indoors and just make music, man.
Yeah.
And watch us on Twitch make music. Yeah.
Let's see what other questions we have here. Does this mean you have to delete the VOD now? What does that mean? The VOD.
Oh, I actually think this VOD is going to stay in the YouTube after. Like
the stream.
Look at it after.
Wait, what does VOD stand for? Video.
Video on demand. I don't know actually.
Video on demand.
What happened to that track that was similar to Total McButtle that the Chainsmokers used to drop? That was actually a very old demo I had, like a drop. I don't know what happened. Like, I just didn't feel it anymore. So I did not want to finish it. But yeah, there was a lot of guys that played it out.
What do you think about Charlotte the Witch? She's actually like one of my favorites, actually. She makes like the best, like baddest techno. She has like the coolest techno sets, 100%. Charlotte the Witch?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she's one of my go-tos for like listening to like any techno sets. She's a big inspiration. You guys should collab with Sick Mode. Yeah, I kind of want to. I kind of want to hit him up. He makes some really cool, like, hardcore shit. Maybe that should happen. We have about, like, 30 seconds before I end the stream. Yeah, guys. Just make sure you follow us on Twitch again. twitch.tv/PsychoBoysClub.
And hit the follow button, and then we can...
Yeah, and also like the rest of our social medias, so if you guys aren't really following. Instagram is Psycho Boys Gram. Twitter is Social Boys Club. Psycho Boys Club. I think I said Social Boys. But
so yeah, we
Social Boys Club. But yeah, guys,
Also, thank you guys for watching, actually. Also, yeah. First break, like, first streaming, actually, too. Just to showcase what we got, like, production-wise. So it's also, like, first time for us.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. I'll see you guys on the next stream, hopefully.
Yes. All right.
Yep. Stay safe. Peace.
Stay safe, man.